Pastor Timothy. I am Reverend David Mbawana. I'm from Enugu State, a distance of about 125 to 30 kilometers from where you are having this very main program. On my own, God has given you a unique ministry that is nowhere.
Praise the Lord.
I was in the West for 19 years. I was in Ireland, I was in London, I was in Greece, I was in Italy, I was in America. I visited Tel Aviv. And I've been meeting teachers, I've been meeting men of God. After listening to you on Monday, and I sat back on my chair, the Holy Spirit started ministering to me that this is what Paul was talking about in the last two verses of 1 Corinthians chapter 12, where he said, "But I teach you a more better way, a more excellent way." This is the right, divinely ordained method of winning souls or evangelism. That is what God allowed me to discover. Because evangelism should be about the love of God that is transmitted down to us through Christ. And this is what you are doing. It requires a right total reorientation of all of us ministers in Nigeria, at least as far as I can say. We are not doing it the way it should be done. We are exerting a lot of energy, strength, force, and we are putting in more and we are getting less results. But from what God has given to you, if we can get back, sit back, and then look at this teaching carefully, digest it. If we can digest what we have in our hands about all these handouts you've prepared and meditate over them, we will first of all repent in ourselves first, because you can't give people what you don't have. This is a matter of the reorientation of the heart, the mind, and the method. So the individual who carries your message must first of all be changed from whom he is before you met him. Personally, I've been asking God, give me a new heart, a new mind, to be able to say what I am and what I do. Because from the time you laid hands on me, I discovered that prayer was not about shouting or trying to force people or push people down. I discovered that there's something in you that makes somebody feel serene, feel cool in the inside, feel very, very just natural in the inside. And after that prayer, personally, I discovered that the prayer does not end with the person. It ends with activities. For instance, after the prayer yesterday evening, the last thing you did, my son, who is in Tanzania, called me. He said, "Did you see the credit of 1,000 I sent to you?" I didn't see it. I've never known about it. I opened my phone, and I discovered that 1,000 was lying in my phone. While I was telling Pastor Asok, I don't have any money in my phone. So it has not happened that way before. So I said, anointing is not force. Anointing is not trying to shout. Anointing is something that is in somebody. The righteousness of somebody, the holiness of somebody, that he transfers to the next person. That's what I learned from your practical teaching. And this is a practical teaching which we need. It's not that, I don't know why I drove over 120 something to 30 kilometers to be here. But when I came in, I started realizing why God will persuade me to be here. And I think all the ministers in my state need to hear this. And right here, I've started thinking and planning how to get major ministers who think we have arrived to come and listen to this type of teaching, so that we can begin to do this thing right. I think this is part of the preparation for the Lord's return, which all people who are called to serve in the kingdom must hear. to be able to prepare themselves very well, to be able to get the congregation along. So I am very happy. I am blessed. To be candid, I am fully blessed. And it's like I would follow you back, because the time you had is not enough for you to deliver to us what you have. When we look at the handouts you've given to us, there are more things you would have spoken of. And in teaching, what you hear from the master's mouth has more force and more power than what he has written down. You may not have that mind to be able to diagnose the statements he has made and to reach the explanation he has given to you on that statement. When you read it, it's just you are reading depending on your mentality, your perception and your understanding. But when you are hearing from the master, it is a whole different thing. That is why God will open the door and you think of returning for a greater and wider program that people will hear and know that we need to change. Our orientation must change. Our minds must change. Our mindset must be focused on the love of Christ. And starting from that love, somebody will demonstrate in our own life. People will be able to welcome us, and then as we deliver and we live the life, ministry will be a little bit very interesting and not a walk again. I am very happy to have left my home to be here. These 4 days I stayed, I regret nothing, but I thank God in everything, and I believe it is not an accident that God brought you here. It has not been easy with you. You see the type of power we have. You have been in a hot environment, hot car, hot air, this thing. Our electricity is not working. But through it all, God gave you the patience to stay with us and deliver to us the much you can deliver because of the shortness of time. I thank God, and I believe that God who brought you here knows the enormity of the need for you to come back, and he will open the door. We thank you so much, Pastor, because the situation here requires you to stay here for 6 months. But I know you also have a congregation home. But God must open the door for you to return and give us more. We thank you very much, Pastor Timothy, because we know that this is God's plan, and it is going to work out beyond this very, very attempt. We thank you very much. May the Lord bless you. And I believe that this is your trip. You will equally experience God's grace in a different dimension in all your movement, both aeroplane and help. God will take you home safely because you've done a great work. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Glory to God. It's God's work. It's, you know, it's God who gave me all this teaching and transformed my life, and give all glory to God.